Hello there, beautiful people. Hope you all are doing well. Hope everyone is safe from the coronavirus, COVID-19, Kung Flu. A little bit of a personal update. I am indeed alive. You have not heard from me in ages because it's been a crazy whirlwind ride for me for the last 6 to 8 months. Just a little bit of a very quick personal update. I was working in the States, as some of you already know. I worked for an American financial services firm specializing in insurance and investment products. Because of my job, I was traveling a lot to Canada since late 2018. The Canadian market has been very generous to us, and our operations here were expanding. One of our offices was having some issues. As all of you know, I am not an American national. I came here for school and I stayed back for the civil liberties. My immigration status in the United States is closely tied to my work status, as is the case. So when my boss suggested that they need help with one of our offices north of the border, I thought about resisting a bit, but the company has been very kind to me. It has opened up a lot of opportunities for me. So for the company's sake, packed up my bags and... I am currently up north. Over the last 7-8 months, not only was there a lot of work with regards to work visa paperwork, I also had to sit for a crazy amount of exams. In the financial services industry, you need various licenses for the different products you work with. So insurance licenses, licenses for stocks, mutual funds, and so on, had to retake all my certifications to work here. So that's been the gist. I think our province has been in lockdown since March 13. I know a lot of folks are struggling. I've been incredibly blessed to be able to work from home, but I understand it is most likely very difficult for many people out there, and it's going to be very difficult for everybody. So if you are in quarantine, there's not much I can do, but I hope I can distract you a little bit. Now, this is not political, so I hope we can all use this for a bit of a distraction. Let's all unite and laugh at what I would say are perhaps one of the most disliked communities online. I am talking about Ethots. Now, different versions of Ethots have existed in many forms online, but lately their species have been developing an incredible amount of narcissism and entitlement. The main source of this entitlement is generally seen in the platform Twitch. Now, I'm sure a lot of people are already familiar with Twitch. It initially started as a gaming platform, but it has now attracted all kinds of talents. And it has attracted all kinds of people with no talents. But it turns out, with the right amount of skin exposure, anyone can make a commercial living on Twitch. Of course, your talent has to be showcased while you're in leggings, and any field of expertise combined with skin exposure and tight leggings work here. For instance, dancing, fashion, fitness.
We are on the move, chat.
You blew out your knee deadlifting 500 pounds. Hey, Real Monte. Can we get a shout out for Real Monte too? And Bale Frost. Can we get a shout out for them? Also, hi guys. What's up?
Awkward admission of stalking.
No. So when you guys don't know to me, it tells me your name that is attached to your PayPal. And if your name is attached to your PayPal and you don't know to me, I look you up on Google. I Google each and every one of your names, and I creep your LinkedIns. A lot of engineers.
Apparently, there's a whole bunch of thirsty dudes who will support just about anything if the right amount of cleavage is exposed. Now, bear in mind, we are in the age of free internet porn, camgirl websites, and Tinder. But somehow, dudes would throw away their hard-earned money on these Ethots. If only there was a word for these people.
Beta!
Now, intense comfort breeds intense entitlement. Enter Invadervie. Invadervie? She has many talents, but what we're about to see is mainly her skills in marketing, economics, and financial consulting.
Oh my, so here we have some excellent 300 IQ comments from the peanut gallery. This conversation sucks. This is weird. Yikes. These are exquisite contributions to a very good conversation. And these people in chat who are making these comments do not appear as immature, childish cheapskates whatsoever.
You all thought I was joking. No. Apparently, this is her way of appealing to
Beta!
Exactly. Let's continue.
It doesn't really matter how much money you make or how much money you have. That's really the thing, because I'm not asking you for a large financial contribution. If it cost $20 to sub, $20 is quite a bit of money. $20 is you can get a full meal for $20, and the difference of $20 and eating a meal is in that $20, like that's where it is. But a sub is $5. At maximum, in whatever your currency is, it's maybe $10.
Now that is some quality economics right there. Milton Friedman and Thomas Sowell got nothing on her.
And it doesn't matter how broke you are, if you have time to watch Twitch, you have $10, truly. If you don't have $10, you probably don't have time to watch Twitch because you should be working, you should be trying to earn money. It's not a ton, it's not like a ton of money. So being like, I'm broke, I can't afford to sub, that doesn't really track. What you mean to say is, I'm so irresponsible with my money, I can't support the entertainment that I enjoy.
And what did I tell you? Wouldn't you hire her to be your financial consultant? Now you might be wondering, is this a new species of entitlement?
So basically all my money goes to bills and food, or I would support you. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Uh-huh. It's $5. It's really, like, no one's gonna convince me that what I'm saying is so rude or so unacceptable or so outrageous. It just simply isn't. It's $5. It doesn't cost you that much to sub. And they're just sitting here masturbating as hard as they possibly can, as quietly as they can, because their parents are in the next room talking about how disappointed they are in them. And they're like, why would I ever pay for this when this slut's giving it away for free? You're right, buddy, you're right.
No. These creatures are not uncommon. They are all around us. Just a few months ago, we had another not-so-rare sighting.
How did my whole speech about how I need subs to get the stream going, if you like the content, blah, 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 how that results in zero subs? There are regulars here. $5 a month. How do you have hours of time to watch me and not $5? I don't know. What are you doing with your life where you have hours of time to watch Twitch and not $5 to provide for the content that you're watching? There are so, look at, I have a wall of non-subs. This is fucking actually really heartbreaking.
This particular adaptation of the human race will only continue and morph into something much more tone-deaf and entitled than we could possibly imagine. This is our creation. We throw money at talentless people, shower them with popularity and wealth, and of course this goes to your heads. And by we, I mean
Beta!
Anywho, you guys, I hope I could distract you a little bit. I will be uploading more frequently. Hopefully, we'll get back to our regular life soon. Talk to everyone. Press some of those buttons below. I think it'll help me stay in touch with you all better. Till next time.
And you're very angry about what I said in that clip. And you're justified in your anger. What I said was tone deaf, insensitive, and stupid.